Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another video in Premium per User series where I'm going to discuss about automatic page refresh or change deduction in Power BI. Let us try to understand what is automatic page refresh or change deduction. So basically, when you want to monitor some critical events, it's important for you your data to be refreshed, right, as soon as source data is updated. In those scenarios, you need to go for automatic page refresh or change deduction option. So this option in Power BI enables your active report page to query for a new data. So you are in the screen while seeing the report, but unless you refresh your page, your data won't get reflected at the latest data, where even it's in the import mode or direct query mode at live connection. So in those cases, you do not need to do anything. Your report page will automatically query when you are in that report. So this feature is very useful when you have some critical reports that requires the live data. So how you can do it? It's fixed interval and change deduction. Using these two options, you can achieve this goal. And mostly this works good with direct query. So when I say change deduction and you can see the latest data, so everyone will thought in an impression like how scheduled refresh, all those things works. Basically, this feature is available for direct query. And when it's import mode, this is not applicable. That is the first point I want to make. Let us try to understand what are the different source or different storage mode that it will support. So basically, when you have a direct query mode, the fixed interval and change deduction both are supported. And when you see the shared capacity, this is different capacities you have, premium per user or premium shared capacity, those things, right? So you can see here dedicated capacities, both change direction and fixed intervals are supported, and how minimum you can able to refresh, right? It is 1 second and here it is 30 minutes. When it comes to import mode, both are not supported. You can either you cannot fixed interval or change direction cannot be supported. So this feature is applicable only you have a direct query. What happens when you have a mixed mode? We already seen about mixed mode. When you see the aggregation table, right? If you haven't watched it, just watch it. What is mixed mode is? So in that cases, whichever having a direct query, then it is supported. Analysis services, Azure and on-premise, only the fixed interval is supported, not change direction is not supported. So you can go through this just to take a snapshot. This is available in the Microsoft website. So let us try to understand and begin in a demo. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. Now we are in Power BI, where you have a simple data here. It can be any other multiple tables as well. Now, where this change deduction option is available. So first of all, you go to modeling. There is an option called change deduction. And you can see here at the bottom, it is a direct query mode. The storage mode is direct query. That is why it is available. Now I have another report that is taken my previous video, where in the modeling tab, this change deduction is not enabled, meaning like this is imported mode, like once you connect to the import and direct query mode, this is the difference. So this report is import mode, so this is not enabled. So for those who do not know how to get direct query or import mode, so if you want to get a data, like I want SQL Server, mostly this is the simplest way, my connection. Here is the option. Basically, once you're connecting to the server, you have import or direct query mode. If you press import mode, then all the data will be imported in Power BI. Direct query, your data won't be loaded into Power BI. That is the difference. So this is not the main purpose of this video. To understand about the page refresh, automatic page refresh, change deduction, right? In order to view, you need to have a direct query. That is what I want to make a point here. Now, once you have this one, where this option, this page refresh which is available is like, click on the page, then go to this formatting, you can see the page refresh. Whereas the import mode, file, you do not have this page refresh option. So that is the difference. Now this page refresh, as we seen before, there is auto page refresh. This is called fixed interval. So every 15 seconds, this page will get reflected. And there is another option called change deduction. So change deduction is for a particular measure. Where what is the main difference between these two is like, the auto page refresh, for every 15 seconds, all the particular visuals right here in this particular page is like, all the queries are fired to the source, then gets the latest data based on the interval set. Whereas the change deduction, what will happen is like, it will check for a particular measure. For a single measure only you can able to configure this change deduction. So assume like check whether any new quantity or anything changes in the sales amount, right? Then it will go and check for a particular figure or measure only. Then only the entire page will be refreshed. So either case, you are refreshing the entire page or entire report based on what you have configured. Let us try to check the first option, auto page refresh, 15 seconds. I have set it to on. Now, you can check the 15 seconds. Now the time is 14:30, right? If there is no change, the data won't get reflected. So almost it is 10 seconds now. Now you can see 45. So from 30, 45, 15 seconds, when there is no change, direct query or any thing will not have any data. So now, as already we configured change auto page refresh 15 seconds, let us go to database and edit some records. So this is my direct query database. Now I'm not going to write any query. Instead, I use Management Studio feature to update some records. Now you can see the data over here. It was 8240. Let us try to increase any one of the count, any one of the record to 5. Okay, increase the value to 5. This quantity, it is 6 now. Let me increase it to 5. Now, immediately as soon as you update it, you go and check here. Within 15 seconds, now automatically it refresh, right? So every 15 seconds it go and refresh. So now you can see from 4.0, the 5 has increased. It was very quick. You cannot able to notice that as well. Even I can reduce it to 2 values. Now from 5, it should become 3. So wait for 15 seconds. So it will happen before 15 seconds, right? See, now it is. So every 15 seconds it is updating. So after 15 seconds, after 5 seconds I updated, within 10 seconds it will get updated. So this is your page refresh. So all the queries are fired. But I don't want to do this. Instead, I want to run based on one particular measure, right? So change deduction should fire based on one particular measure. So what should I do? Now for this, go to add change deduction. Here is the catch here. Now you cannot use the default measure, like whatever you choose, already created measure, cost per unit, or the default measure, I mean, you need to create one. Okay, for that only you can able to create it. So it's existing or new one. So existing means you cannot able to choose. There is an option to choose. You can see there is an option to choose. The option box will appear. There is no existing measure. These are the default measure from the database. That is, integer value will consider as a summation or measure. Now for this, create a new measure. Okay, so I want to check for the sales amount, is there any changes or quantity. Okay, now I will go for quantity now. So just drag and drop, you choose the calculation, sum of quantity. Okay, for how many minutes, or I will go for seconds to test it quickly. I will increase it to 20 seconds. So this configuration, I will come to this later, based on the admin configuration will override this value. That we will discuss later. Now I have set this one quantity. Whenever the quantity changes, okay, in 20 seconds, the entire report will change. Now click on OK. Now you can see here one measure is created with the change deducted icon over here, right? Change deduction sum for quantity. This is the name, the measure name, and 20 seconds. Okay, so whether you use this measure or not, that doesn't matter. You have used this one, and then the entire report will get refreshed. So let me take, instead of the direct quantity, I will use this quantity here, the change deduction quantity. So change deduction sum of quantity 8243, right? Now let me go to the database. Now what happens to this, right? Now I will put 5, so I increase the three quantities here, so 8243 will become 8246. So let's wait for 20 seconds. It may be happen before that as well. So I have updated it. Yes, now you can see the value has changed. The 20 seconds is too long. It is taking some time. So now this is the main objective of your change deduction. Now what happens when I use change deduction, right, for some other measure, but it is not changing. You are changing only the quantity. What I'm trying to say is, now I have said like change deduct changes when there is a change in the quantity. Okay, now I'm going to change the frequency here, edit changes. Let us try to reduce 10. Okay, let us try to see it very quickly. Now I will increase some other value to 4 values. Okay, 13 from 9 I reduce, increase to 4. Okay, now it will become 8250. Yeah, it has changed now. Now what I'm trying to say is, I'm saying change deduction on the quantity measure, but I'm going to change on the sales amount. This sales amount from 800 I've increased to 1000. I updated to 1000. Now whether this will refresh this page or not, that is a question. It will not refresh. Why? Because you go and check only for that particular column, the change deduction, right, on this particular sum quantity, then only refresh the entire page. I have updated the sales amount column. Now this will not work. So that is the catch here. You need to understand this can be configured for one particular measure, and that measure should be a crucial of this report, right? Such a measure you need to configure, whereas the same column, now it is more than 10 to 20 seconds, I have updated the sales amount, this report is not yet updated, right? But now you can see when I change this one to auto page refresh, right, in 15 seconds, this will get affected because the entire page will get refreshed irrespective of whatever has changed in the data source. Now let us wait for 15 seconds. This sales amount is increased now while we are talking. You can see 500. Now let me increase another 500 in the sales amount. Okay, now what happens? It will become 7000. Okay, auto page refresh. If you want multiple measures to be considered, then you need to choose auto page refresh. When you have a single particular key measure that has to be monitored for every few seconds, then you need to choose change direction for a particular measure. I hope you understand this. And one last thing I want to highlight is, like, you can see this particular values over here. This is purely based on the app settings that we configure over here. So for the admin portal, I mean to say, in order to access the admin, go to this three dots in the admin user, admin portal, where you can check here the premium per user features or configurations, the automatic page refresh, change detection, and data set workload settings. I hope I have covered about XMLA. I mean, I didn't cover. Basically, I used how to check the incremental refresh using XMLA. So these are the things. Only if you are admin enabled, then these features will work out. So you configure change detection or automatic page refresh in your desktop, but in your Power BI services, once you deploy, in order to work it, if your admin disabled it, this will not work. And you have configured 10 seconds here, but here you see 30 seconds. This will override, this will take the priority. So in order to sync, either your admin has to reduce it, or your admin knows much better than you how frequently it should work based on the reporting. There should be a someone has to compensate. Either your admin should reduce this timing, or your report should be changed to 30 seconds based on the company policies. So these are the things. Once you publish this particular report, after you configure it, the same behavior will be available in the Power BI services for the other users. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.